2023 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship.
And nails the landing.
Oh, and she does it to perfection.
That might have done it for the Sooners. Their sixth championship in 9 seasons. The Sooners untouchable today in Fort Worth, Texas.
Watching Sooner Women's Gymnastics presented by OU Health on Sooner Vision from ESPN Plus. Back-to-back national titles celebrated tonight, the sixth overall for Sooner Women's Gymnastics. Tonight, they welcome the Denver Pioneers to the Lloyd Noble Center. And my partner was a part of a couple of the banner-raising ceremonies, the former Sooner, formerly Natalie Brown, and now Natalie Walker. These two teams competed last week out in Denver. Oklahoma won and scored a 198 in the process. What does that say about where the Sooners are with regard to a three-peat?
Yeah, it just shows that Oklahoma is in a lane of their own, and having done that on the road for 3 consecutive weeks makes it even more impressive. You can see it in their consistency, those small details. They look postseason ready to me.
Well, the Sooners set to go tonight. We take a look at kind of a season snapshot on both of these teams. Start with Oklahoma. Give us the lowdown on where the Sooners are, Natalie.
Yeah, so OU is ranked number one nationally right now. You know, they hit a 198 last week, and they've been on the road for 3 consecutive weeks. So having that average season high of 198.025 is truly incredible.
And for Denver, they also had a season high last week, and they're going to get a chance to start on what is their best rotation. That'll be the Barbers.
Yeah, you know, Denver's had a good season so far. Last week was obviously their best meet so far this season. Their coach was saying how they hit some events there, they hit some events here, but they really got to put it all together, and hopefully they do that tonight.
Our Sooner to Watch tonight, presented by OU Health, proud to be Oklahoma's flagship academic health system. It is Jordan Bowers. What an amazing gymnast she has been, just a junior. She won the all-around last week. Where is she right now as a gymnast?
Yeah, you know, Coach Kindler was expressing how Jordan has grown so much, especially on the balance beam since her freshman year. You know, while she's already so fierce, you can tell her confidence has grown as well.
And as far as gymnasts individually in this meet, it's hard to find one better than Denver's Jessica Hutchinson, the senior out of Gilbertsville, Pennsylvania. She is the back-to-back Big 12 Gymnast of the Year. And head coach Melissa Kutcher-Reinhardt said it's hard to find words to describe her. How would you describe her?
Yeah, you know, what I see from Jessica is such a cool, calm demeanor. She has impeccable lines, and she is so beautiful to watch on every event that she competes.
Before we get this meet started, we jump into a chance to talk about Denver a little bit more and the momentum this program has. When we talked with Melissa Kutcher-Reinhardt, we asked, is there momentum from last season when you finished 8th nationally? She said, really, this probably goes back to 2019, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. And you can see it from gymnasts like Maddie Carr, Lindsey Brown. And in 2021, I mean, Denver beat Oklahoma in the Big 12 championship, and that kind of has set up the program to continue. And so if they continue to build on that, who knows what else could happen.
There's Melissa Kutcher-Reinhardt in her 26th season, 50 seasons of Denver gymnastics. In fact, their hashtag is hashtag Team 50. But they have made 24 consecutive NCAA regionals, ranked number 12 in the country, and they're 5-1, of course, with that loss to Oklahoma out in Denver last week. It's actually the second of 3 times these teams will meet this year, so that is definitely different. But she said, there's no place I would rather get on a plane and go than to Norman, Oklahoma this weekend to test myself and my team against the best. Before we get started, let's jump into Natalie's keys. They are presented by Riverwind Casino. It's always a good time. What's important for Oklahoma tonight?
Yeah. So the keys to the meet tonight are really just harness the crowd's energy. You know, they're at home for the first time this year, and then just pay attention to those small details that they've already been hitting so far this season on the road.
Audrey Davis is first up on vault.
Has a great setup off that vault. You can see her legs just separate just a little bit. She has been working on it, but they can't quite get them together yet, but just a small hop on the landing and a good start for Oklahoma.
She's also one of four Sooners who will compete in the all-around tonight. That's a big storyline. Each team has four competitors in the all-around in this contest here tonight.
Yeah, and that's the most all-arounders Oklahoma has had in quite a long time.
Rose Casale will be up first. A senior from Weddington, North Carolina. She's a fourth-year gymnast, so she's been in the program a good deal of time.
A beautiful chaposh there. Really hitting those handstands so far in this routine. Ends with a double layout. Tries to hold on to that stick, but doesn't quite get it and has to take a small hop.
She was a WGCA postseason All-American on bars a season ago, was Rosie Casale. Set to go back to the vault for the Sooners. And she's off to a great start already. Just a freshman, Hannah Shibley. Already three scores of 9.9 plus in three meets so far this year.
Yeah, and she's been the event specialist for the Big 12 2 weeks in a row. She does a unique front handspring pike half. That wasn't as good as we saw from last week where she got a 9.95. She had to, you see, just take a small hop forward. Just didn't get enough block off the table.
You can see the Canadian bridge from her home gym. And her parents were her coaches growing up. In fact, dad was her vault coach. Got to be pretty proud of that one.
Yeah, and Coach Kindler was saying she's almost still in awe of being at Oklahoma. But the last couple of weeks, she's seen her own it more.
Audrey Davis had a 9.825 for the Sooners. We'll see about the score of Shibley. We get back over to Kylie Rorick, set to take her turn on the bars for the Pioneers. Have not yet seen the score for Rosie Casale.
Kylie is an All-American on this event.
In fact, second team All-American last year. Sophomore, she's from Charlotte, North Carolina. We'll see her in the leadoff on the floor exercise later tonight.
Holds on to that handstand right there. Beautiful blind change to Jaeger. Nice shoot over. Slightly misses that last handstand heading into her dismount now. Has such good height on that double layout and got that stick.
Well, Rosie Casale had a 9.75. We'll await the score of Rorick and look again at the dismount.
Here's that dismount again. You can really just see that pop off the bar. Her chest is high when she lands. That's exactly what the judges want to see.
Sooners have a 9.825 from Davis, a 9.675 from Shibley, and now Kat Lavasser will be next up on vault.
Kat is capable of scoring a 10 on this event and nearly did last week. Almost gets a stick there, just has to take a small step, but that is a beautiful vault.
All-American on vault a couple of years ago, and she was the third Sooner to win Big 12 Event Specialist of the Year, the third in a row last year. Good crowd tonight at the Lloyd Noble Center. Let's look again.
You can see good pop off that vault table. Wasn't able to hold the stick there, but a beautiful vault overall.
Did score a perfect 10 on vault against Alabama a season ago. So we have seen Casale and Rorick. Rorick, a 9.825 on the bars a moment ago. And Madison Ulrich set to take her turn. She's a freshman from Fort Mill, South Carolina. Five-star recruit, very high level, said Coach Melissa Kutcher-Reinhart. So this sort of competition is not new to her on this level.
No, and she's already been the Big 12 newcomer of the week two times. And her coach was saying she definitely has All-American potential. Doesn't quite get that handstand on that pirouette there. Nails that last one, though. Let's see what she does on her dismount. Beautiful double layout, and she holds on to that stick. They're starting to get some momentum going here.
Her work ethic matches her talent, said Melissa Kutcher-Reinhart, and it's evident right here.
Here's that dismount again. Legs glued together, holds onto that stick. Beautiful.
Set to go back to the vault. A 9.825 from Davis, 9.675 from Shively. Levasseur had a 9.9, and here's Jordan Bowers.
Nice pop off that table. Doesn't get the stick, but it's a beautiful vault. Oklahoma last week had 3 out of 6 vaults stuck. So far, they haven't stuck one, so hopefully they can get some here.
And in addition to being ranked number one overall, the Sooners are number one nationally on the vault. Set to go back to the bars, and this will be Amia Hebink, the junior from Lone Tree, Colorado.
Beautiful handstand right there. Great combination from that release down to the low bar. So far, I'm seeing such great attention to detail from this team. Doesn't quite get that stick on the landing. Has to take a small step back, but that was a very clean routine. She does a cool release. It's actually pretty unique, called a Rikna right there, and then goes down to the low bar.
Sooners moving right through their vault rotation. Kiera Wells, very talented freshman. She's from Augusta, Kansas.
She had a little trouble in warm-ups, but she's a competitor, so let's see what she does here. Nails it. Great block off the table, gets so much distance, just has to take that small step. And KJ says, Coach Kindler says she's still working on finding those landings. Here's that vault again. Great block off the table, great distance, just a little bit too much power. Again, she's just a freshman.
Her 9.825 last week on vault was her highest of the year. We'll see what that scores for Kiera Wells. Mia Hebink just given a 9.85 on the bars. Good solid rotation going for the Pioneers. And here's Jessica Hutchinson.
You'll see such beautiful lines from Jessica here. Beautiful chaposh. Right into the pack. To the low bar. Just her dismount now. Beautiful double layouts. Another stuck dismount for Denver.
Comes from a gymnastics family. Mom Sylvia, Grandma Maya were both Bulgarian Olympians.
Here's that dismount again. Beautiful legs together. Lands with her chest up. Heels touch. Really holds it.
So Kiera Wells had a 9.825 for the Sooners. The high score so far is Levasseur's 9.9, as we see Faith Torres now.
Had a 9.925 last week. Just a little bit short there on that landing. You can tell she had to save it by taking a step back.
We'll have a couple of exhibitions on vault for the Sooners. Faith Torres, the sixth and final official competitor. We'll get the Sooners score in just a moment, but final competitor now for the Pioneers on the bars is Riley Mundell, senior from Parker, Colorado, and she's top 10 nationally on this rotation.
A beautiful Takachev to start off her routine. Misses that handstand just by a smidge. Just her dismount here. Beautiful double layout. Just a small hop in place. Not sure what the judges are going to do with that, but a great routine and a great rotation. Here's here's that dismount one more time. You see on the landing, has to take a small hop in place, but really sells it right there.
So Oklahoma's rotation is done on vault. Now we will see the exhibitions. And first up for the Sooners,
Soraya.
See the two exhibitions, and we see the Georgia transfer, Soraya Hawthorne.
She's so powerful on this event. And as you can see, just maybe a little bit too powerful right there. Has such great block off the table. Just needs to work on that control of the landing.
Oklahoma's vault score 49.175. Once again, Hawthorne was an exhibition. One more exhibition coming for the Sooners on vault. We get to Momoko Iwai, an exhibition on the bars for Denver.
Starting off their routine well, nailing that handstand in that transition there. Beautiful. Just a small hop on that dismount, but overall a really good exhibition for her and gives her more experience on this event.
And so the final competitor we will see will be Sheridan Ramsey with an exhibition for the Sooners on vault.
Sheridan does a Yurchenko full, which does not start from a 10.0, but she does it really well. Good block off the table, small hop backwards. I love the landing, holds it there.
She
has a career high of a 9.875 on this event.
Well, one rotation is in the books, and the Pioneers have a slight lead over the Sooners after the initial rotation. Denver scoring a 49.325. On the uneven bars, and the Sooners a 49.175. Here's Kat Levasseur.
Kat had a beautiful vault. Just a small step there, but very nice control, and that's definitely what you want to see.
So that is the high score so far on vault after the Sooners have taken their rotation. KJ Kindler talking things over. You see Denver going to have a lead of about a tenth and a half as we head to rotation number two. I think the youngsters are enjoying it, and we are as well. Banner raising night for Sooner women's gymnastics. And Denver has a lead after the opening rotation. We're back to the Lloyd Noble Center after this.
Sooner Sports TV is brought to you by Air Comfort Solutions, your total home solution for plumbing, heating, air conditioning, and electrical. Make the winning call today. Mathis Home, official furniture sponsor of OU Athletics. Pizza Hut, the official pizza of the Sooners. Riverwind Casino, it's always a good time.
The six-time national championship-winning head coach, KJ Kindler, in her 18th season. Sooners raising the banner earlier tonight. Back-to-back national championships, pursuing a third in a row. So where does the motivation come from? She said it's the little things, it's the details. Maybe there are those who might doubt you or say things about you. She said, we're motivated by that, but she finds ways to continually motivate her team and her program, Natalie.
Yeah, and every single year, Coach Kindler comes up with a different theme to use, and it's top secret. No one really finds out about it until after Nationals.
They are first on beam and vault, third, you see, and fourth, no lower than fourth on any rotation. And here's a little bit of the uniqueness for Oklahoma this year in that they have four all-arounders, whereas typically they might have one or two.
Yeah, and I mentioned it a little bit earlier. It's very unique for Oklahoma to have three all-arounders, yet four all-arounders. The last 10 years, I think there's been maybe one or two, but KJ's Coach Kindler says that it's not a strategy. It's just happened to be that way.
Denver also with four all-arounders tonight. Now, you certainly expect Jessica Hutchinson, the two-time Big 12 gymnast of the year, but Madison Ulrich, Rose Casale, and Riley Mundell, these are experienced gymnasts as well, so they are certainly very capable of producing good all-around scores.
Yeah, and you can see that so far in their bars lineup and how they just performed. They're experienced. A lot of them are seniors, and they're showing it tonight.
In fact, if you look through, Ulrich is the only non-senior, and she's a freshman. Now, she's a high-level freshman, as we talked about a little bit earlier. Denver motivated after Oklahoma won at Denver a week ago, and it's the Pioneers with a bit of a lead after the opening rotation. Are you surprised? How did that take place?
I am a little bit surprised. Oklahoma had some uncharacteristic mistakes on vault. Last week on vault, they were lights out. They nailed 3 out of 6 landings, and this week they didn't get one. You know, it's just something they'll just have to go back in the gym and fix, but they're still working on some of their control, including from sophomore Faith Torres. Coach Kindler says that on floor and on beam, she's quite automatic, but on vault, she's still working to nail in that control.
So the high score on bars came from Ulrich, and we get over first to Mila Brush.
Starts off with a beautiful Yurchenko full. Slides her feet just a tad, but that was a great landing and a great start for Denver.
Mila Brush, sophomore from Cincinnati, had knee surgery last year, so not full go just yet, but we do see her on the ball. She had a 9-8 last week. Set to go with the Sooner vault lineup, or I should say uneven bars lineup. Severs, Lavasser, Torres, Reagan Smith, and Davis. Jordan Bowers, and we'll see Sullivan with the exhibition a little bit later. First off is Severs.
Danny is such a great starter on this event. So beautiful. Week after week, it's like you're watching the same routine, just hitting her handstands. Nails that last handstand heading into her dismount now. Great landing. Again, like I said, same each week, starting off this bars lineup so well.
Fantastic landing there for Severs, the junior from Gary, Indiana.
Here's that dismount again. Great, solid landing and holds it there, so the judges see. Great start for Oklahoma.
Three All-American honors in her Sooner career. And I think we just missed the vault of Madison Reidenbach, one of the freshmen. Here's another look at it.
Another Yurchenko full. Has a flare out, which is very beautiful. Just a small hop backwards.
Oh, thank goodness for replay. We got Madison Reidenbach, freshman from Hudson, Wisconsin. Set to go back for the Sooners, Kat Lavasser. Next on the uneven bars. Should mention Danny Severs working her way back from a little stress reaction in her leg around Thanksgiving. So we'll see more on her plate probably as the season goes along.
Yes, exactly. And just finding that endurance again on all the other events might take a little bit, but she's definitely capable.
Here's Kat Lavasser in the all-around tonight. We've already seen her go on vault.
Kat is so beautiful on this event. Beautiful Takachev. Nails that handstand. Has a season high of a 9.925. Almost gets that stick right there, just a small step, but those details do matter. Here's that beautiful Takachev over the bar. Exquisite form in her legs.
Lavasser already has the high score on vault tonight, that 9-9. Here's Madison Ulrich on vault for Denver.
Just a freshman and so much confidence. Does a forwards vault, front handspring, front pike, half. Lands a little bit with her chest down, but finds the landing, just a small hop. Just a little bit uneasy there on that landing, but finds the landing again just to prevent from an even bigger step.
So Ulrich has the high score on the uneven bars until a moment ago when we got Danny Siever's score, which was also a 9-9, waiting on Kat Levasseur's score and on Faith Torres to hop on the uneven bars here. Good vault start so far for Denver, a 9.825 from Brush, and Reidenbach has a 9.8. So the Pioneers continue to perform well. As we told you, 9.9 for Danny Siever's for the Sooners, and Kat Levasseur's score is upcoming.
Yeah, what it's really going to come down to tonight is the landings from both teams. You can tell that both teams have really great form on most of their routines, but those little details matter, including the landings.
So here is Faith Torres. She is fifth nationally in the all-around, 10th on vault, 3rd on beam. She's magnificent on beam. We'll see her later on tonight, but she's set to go on the uneven bars. Levasseur scored just in a 9.775.
Faith hits that first handstand. Beautiful, huge Ray. Doesn't quite get that handstand on the high bar before her dismount, but finds the landing right there for the stick.
Faith Torres drawing the applause from the crowd at the Lloyd Noble Center.
And she's getting that momentum back for her team. A 9.775 for Kat was a little bit uncharacteristic there.
Riley Mundell on vault. Denver
beautiful
going strong.
Yurchenko
on
1.5 right there. Just a small hop on the landing, but you can tell from her face how excited and good that must have felt.
There's real momentum with Denver. 9.825 from Brush, 9.8 from Reidenbach, and a 9.85 from Ulrich just prior to Mundell's vault right there. Reagan Smith ready to go next for the Sooners on the uneven bars as we await the score of Faith Torres. So Denver not backing down. In fact, you look at it overall, they may have increased their lead so far through the first few competitors on these rotations.
You know, it's hard coming back and competing at home after being away for 3 weeks straight. And this is their first meet in front of all of their fans, which is a little bit intimidating. So hopefully they settle in here now with Reagan Smith. Beautiful high-flying Ray over the bar. She has just grown so much on this event. Nails that handstand. Holds that last handstand heading into her dismount now. Holds on to that stick. Wow. Great routine for Reagan Smith, getting her team back in the game.
Indeed, the fifth-year competitor from Lewisville, Texas, sticking the landing.
Definitely a veteran move right there. Just gaining that momentum back for her team.
We just saw a 9-9 from Riley Mundell. Here's Rosie Casale.
She has such a great Yurchenko 1.5. You can tell by the distance and the block off the table. She just had to take a small step. It was over the line. Not quite sure what the judges can do with that.
So Casale, the senior from Weddington, North Carolina, has a very serious side, but a free spirit, said Melissa Kutcher-Reinhart, the kind of free spirit that every team needs. She's also the kind of performer that every team needs. And we'll get her score in just a moment. Just saw Faith Torres. Her score was a 9-9 for the Sooners. Reagan Smith has been given a 9-9. The Sooners have 3 9-9s now on the bars. We are awaiting Audrey Davis to take her turn. This is close and highly competitive.
Audrey is beautiful to watch on this event. And Coach Kindler says that nobody can swing bars like Audrey.
In fact, she said, it's time for a 10 for this gymnast on bars. That's exactly what she said, wasn't it?
She is long due for a 10. You can just see like the excellence in every skill that she does, from the knees to the toe point to the nailing of the handstands, and just the unique combinations that she does. Just her dismount now. Gets that stick. What a great routine from Audrey Davis. That might have been the best dismount I've seen from her in a while.
Is that a 10?
It's I'm not going to say
sometime.
It. I don't want to jinx it.
Big hug from KJ Kindler there. Sooners 3-9-9s on the uneven bars. Just saw Rose Casale score a 9-9 for Denver on the vault. Jessica Hutchinson in the anchor position here for the Pioneers.
Another Yurchenko 1.5 right there, and she holds on to that landing.
Wow.
Wow. Wow is right.
That might be the best vault we've seen tonight. We'll see what the score tells us, but we get to see it again.
As she was entering on this vault, it almost seems she punched off the board there, but she was able to find that landing. You can see she did have a small hop right there, so they're gonna take for that.
Yeah, didn't see the flag go up there. Yep. So they will deduct her slightly for that landing. Sooners Jordan Bowers, Audrey Davis, a 9.925 prior to this, the final competitor.
Nails her first handstand. Beautiful Pike Yeager. Jordan has such great rhythm through her motions on bars. Nails that last handstand. And holds on for the stick. Wow.
She was the Big 12 champion on bars last season with routines just like that, wrapping things up for the Sooners on bars. We will see an exhibition for Oklahoma here in just a moment.
Yeah, that routine was definitely superb. I'm not quite sure the judges are throwing out 10s tonight, but
stingy.
That might be the highest for Oklahoma on bars.
We have just seen the highest vault score of the night coming from Jessica Hutchinson. So she's going to win the vault title individually. We await Jordan Bowers' score on the uneven bars. Audrey Davis currently has that high score, a 9.925. So both teams are done on these rotations as far as the regular competitors. But we are set for an exhibition. These exhibitions are important. Malin Sullivan, the senior from Kansas City, finally healthy. She's basically a freshman, even though classification-wise, she's a senior because she has not been healthy.
Yeah, it's tough to sit out for injuries, and I've had past teammates that I've had to do so. And you just really need to get that experience. And Coach Kindler says that she's getting that finally this year, and she's handling it really well. Beautiful handstand, just her dismount now. Just a little bit, she lets go just a little bit too soon and gets good distance, but maybe not enough height and has to take a small step forward.
Exhibition there for the Sooners. Malin Sullivan didn't compete a season ago and didn't compete in 2021 due to injury. So just nice to see her being able to be back out there and compete. It is close at the Lloyd Noble Center. Halfway through this meet, the Pioneers feeling very, very confident, as they should. Denver just scored 4.9425 on their vault rotation. Oklahoma had a 4.9175. The Sooners, though, a 4.96 on their bars rotation, better than what Denver did. And it is close as far as the overall score in this meet. Denver has a lead of a quarter of a temp. 0.025 is their lead. 25/100ths of a point. 25/100ths. That's how close it is right now, Natalie.
Yeah, it's close. And like I said, it's going to come down to those tiny details, including landings on dismounts. And because Oklahoma didn't get one landing on vault, they're really going to have to dial it in here on beam and on floor.
Jordan Bowers wins the uneven bars, close to perfect. Here's a 9.975 from her, Natalie, as we go to break.
There's that beautiful routine from Jordan again. Opens with that Pike Yeager. Lakers at dismount. Holds that landing there. Definitely 9975 worthy.
Denver still leads, but by the slimmest of margins. Halfway through this meet at the Lloyd Noble Center on ESPN Plus. Welcome back to the Lloyd Noble Center. Opening night for Sooner Women's Gymnastics at home. They raised the championship banner before we got things started, and we have a good one after two rotations. Our Air Comfort Solutions scoring update. Air Comfort Solutions, your total home solution for plumbing, heating, air conditioning, and electrical. Make the winning call today. So Denver led by a tenth and a half after one rotation. The Sooners with their 49-6, which was above their season average on the uneven bars, have taken a lead by a quarter of a tenth of a point. 25 one-hundredths of a point is the slimmest of margins. What do you think so far the way these two teams have performed that way?
Yeah, so Oklahoma started off really slow while Denver started off hot. And they're continuing to stay hot, too. Oklahoma recovered over there on the bars to gain some momentum back into this meet and really, you know, take the lead, take back the lead.
Denver's uneven bars rotation was above their season average. Their vault rotation was a season high for the Pioneers, 49-425. We check back in on the all-arounders. We highlighted Jordan Bowers and Jessica Hutchinson, and it is all even in the all-around between two fierce competitors so far, Natalie.
Yeah, Jordan had a fabulous bar routine, almost scoring a 10 with a 9.975.
So Jordan Bowers at 9.975 wins the uneven bars individual event title tonight. She's got her eyes on the all-around prize as well. Been in a heated battle with Jessica Hutchinson, the two-time Big 12 Gymnast of the Year. This is fun, great environment, and this is what KJ Kindler's teams always do. They test themselves against the very best in the country. They recognize how good this Denver program is and how big a meet this can be.
Yes, they do, and we're still early on in the season, and it's okay for these small mistakes. You know, you got to get them out and get experience for every single one of these gymnasts.
Set to go with Audrey Davis leading off the Sooner beam rotation.
Audrey is a leadoff on three out of four of the events that she competes. Coach Kindler said that most people assume that when you put a gymnast first, they're the weakest, but in this case, it's the opposite. She's so mentally tough and a veteran on this event. Opened up with a beautiful backhand spring layout, and then right there, front aerial. She's just so captivating. Feet jump to split ring. So steady so far and confident. Just her dismount here. Round off, double full, just a tiny hop, but a great start for Oklahoma on the balance beam from Audrey Davis.
You mentioned she is the leadoff on three different rotations for the Sooners. How important is it, and what does that say about her mental makeup?
Yeah, it says a lot. It says that she is able to stay calm and cool and really represent Oklahoma well and start off on each event and calm the nerves of some of her other teammates.
Certainly would appear that she has done that. She was an All-American from the get-go on the beam as a freshman. Here's Kylie Rorick leading things off for Denver on the floor exercise.
Starts off with a punch front to a double back. Nicely done. Known mostly for her bars, but this year she is stepping up on this event. Coach Kutcher Reinhardt said.
New to the leadoff spot on the floor exercise this year.
Yeah. She She'll end with a double pike, just two passes. Good last pass. Just landed a little bit sunk in those knees. Great start for Denver on the floor.
So the floor exercise is Denver's lowest ranking nationally on any rotation. They are 23rd nationally, but they've already overperformed on the first two rotations. Why would they not carry that over to the floor exercise?
Yeah, it's definitely starting right here and opening with that first routine. That was a great start.
Audrey Davis had a 9.825 for the Sooners on the beam. Next up, Kiera Wells.
She's just a freshman. Coach Kindler is very impressed with her and how she's getting more comfortable. It's unique side aerial and switches her foot before she lands. Don't see that a lot. Switch leap to a switch jump. Competing as a freshman for your first time at home is not easy, especially on the bounce beam, but she is handling it like a pro. You can tell she's a little bit more confident here and relaxed heading into that dismount. Round off, 1.5, tries to hold on to that stick, doesn't quite get it, but that is a great first routine for her in the Lloyd Noble.
KJ Kindler says Wells may be the most consistent performer on the team on the balance beam. We'll get her score in a moment. Audrey Davis had a 9.825 prior to her. Just saw Kylie Rorick's score posted on floor exercise for Denver in the leadoff position and a very solid score of 9.85. Next up is Momoko Iwai, the junior from Dallas.
Opens with a 1.5 punch layout. Coach Kutcher Reinhardt says that she is always doing those extra numbers and she just adores her. You can tell in the faces of all of these gymnasts that they know how close this is. They're really putting it all on the line. Momo does a two-pass floor routine as well and will end with a double back. A little hesitant on that landing there. Good routine from her. Again, just on that last pass, you can just tell she was a little bit hesitant on that landing.
If there is a rotation where one team might be able to separate in the overall score, it could be here. Oklahoma is number one nationally on the beam, and Denver is 23rd on the floor exercise. Sooners have a 9.825 from Davis and a 9.8 from Wells so far. And next up will be Jordan Bowers.
Yeah, those first two scores aren't quite their scores that Oklahoma is used to getting. However, they're not bad.
Jordan Bowers has had a perfect 10 in her career on every event except the beam.
She'll start off her routine with a back handspring layout. Beautiful, rock solid. Split leap to a switch half. Just looked so confident on this event. As I mentioned earlier, Coach Kindler is so proud of the growth that she's had. just has her dismount now. Let's see if she can get that stick. Run off double full, hold on to that stick. Wow. Get Oklahoma back in the game, Jordan Bowers.
We'll see if it's the perfect 10. Maybe not. It's going to happen at some point for her.
Here's that series again. Solid. And then here's that stick. Nails it.
Back over to the floor exercise, Riley Mundell. We just saw Momo Iwai score a 9-8-2-5 moments ago for Denver.
Wasn't in the lineup last week. Opens up with a front layout to front full. Nearly steps out of bounds right there, but stays it.
Riley Mundell did a NASA internship in California this past summer, a physics major. That's a whole new level.
So impressive to be able to balance that and gymnastics. Tuck. Solid routine from her. Another two-pass routine for Denver, but very, very solid.
Riley Mundell, the senior from Parker, Colorado. 9-8-5 from Rorick. EY with a 9-8-2-5 so far. Back to the Sooners. Faith Torres after we just saw Jordan Bowers register a 9-9-2-5.
Faith has been so consistent on this event ever since her freshman year. And as Coach Kindler says, automatic.
Ranked third nationally this year on the beam.
A little bit uncharacteristic right there from her. Not quite sure if I've seen that. Just was a little bit off on that side aerial going into that back layout. Oklahoma just a little bit shaken up right now. Ends with a beautiful dismount, back handspring gainer full. Great recovery from her. Obviously not the best routine she has done. There's that series again. You can just see she's a little bit off. However, she was able to save it. You know, not every gymnast is gonna be perfect each week. She's just a sophomore, and this is their first time competing at home in front of a pretty large crowd.
A gymnast that doesn't overthink it. Incredible muscle memory for Faith Torres. And we'll see what her score is in just a moment. Rosie Casale now on the floor exercise, fourth competitor for Denver on this rotation.
Rudy back layout. Denver team having fun on the sidelines over there, cheering her on. You know, they really look comfortable competing against Oklahoma at home. Just her last pass now. She does a 2.5 punch front. Gorgeous. I would take absolutely nothing from that. Thank you.
Rosie Casale on floor exercise.
Wow, that was a great routine.
The best we've seen perhaps from the Pioneers so far tonight.
Yep, here's that opening pass, Rudy back layout. Typically you'll see a gymnast do a step out of it, but she lands on 2 feet, and there's that last pass again. Just gorgeous.
So we will see Casale score. We get over to Kat Levasseur for the Sooners on beam after Faith Torres scored an uncharacteristically low 9.7 just a moment ago.
Kat is a veteran. She is a senior. So solid on this event. And beautiful. Opens up with a back handspring layout. I'm just seeing a little bit of nerves from this team right now. Beautiful leap right there. They just need to relax and do what they do and practice. I'm sure Coach Kindler is telling them that before their routines and those pre-beam talks. Looking a lot more confident now, heading into her dismount. Back handspring, gainer full, holds on to that stick. Make sure to milk it, Kat Levasseur.
Indeed she did, and well deserved. Kathleen Levasseur also competing in the all-around tonight. She did just one event last year in the NCAAs for the Sooners, and testament to her work ethic, she's now an all-arounder, Natalie.
Yeah, she's really stepped up this year, and she told Coach Kindler she had more to give, and she's shown that so far this season.
Well, we get back over to the floor exercise. Just saw the high score for Denver so far from Rose Casale, a 9.875. Now it's Madison Ulrich. This freshman, super talented. Already the two-time Big 12 newcomer of the week and performing well again this evening.
Yeah, she already just looked so confident in her fourth meet of the season. Opens up with a double back. So far, an excellent routine. You know, looking at her routine from last week and this week, she looks like a veteran. She doesn't look like a freshman to me. Into her routine with a double pike. Great last pass from her, super solid and excellent.
She had a 9.9 earlier tonight on the uneven bars. And not performing like a freshman at all.
Here's that last pass again. Beautiful double pike. Really nails that landing. Score high for sure.
Reagan Smith for the Sooners now.
Scored a 9.975 last week.
We just saw Kat Levasseur with a 9.9. This is the final competitor for the Sooners on the beam.
Reagan starts off with a back handspring layout. I always say she has such great tempo on this event. Beautiful front aerial, just the rhythm. so good. Straddle half to a swing down. Wow, that was gorgeous. All right, all that's left is her dismount. Back handspring gainer, full, holds on to that stick. Wow, Chad, I don't know. That was pretty perfect to me.
I didn't see much of anything wrong. The nine-time NCAA All-American Reagan Smith. Let's look again.
Here's that jump again into the swing down. Just perfect. The best I've seen her do it. Her dismount, perfect.
Did we just see her sixth career 10 on beam?
It's a 10 from me.
They've been stingy tonight.
Just a little bit.
Don't you be stingy down there now. Pretty perfect there from Reagan Smith. And the final competitor now for the Pioneers on the floor exercise, Jessica Hutchinson.
Starts off with a front double twist. Had a little bit of an awkward landing there. She's just so beautiful to watch. Her long lines. Round off 1.5 front layout. Denver's really nailing all of their landings so far and showing a lot of confidence. I see the score right now for Reagan Smith, 9.975. Didn't quite get the 10, but.
Stingy.
Just a little bit. Now Jessica's last pass here. Front Rudy to a straddle jump. Beautiful. Great routine for Jessica to close out this rotation for Denver.
And it's going to be close. You see, before that, the lead for Oklahoma, 1.5 tenths of a point was all before that routine by Jessica Hutchinson. There's some nervous moments, without a doubt, inside the Lloyd Noble Center, Natalie Brown.
There are. And it really comes down to those tiny details. And unfortunately, Oklahoma's missed some today, but they've really fought to gain it back.
This is exhibition time, and again, these are super important. Don't count toward the overall score, but Ava Sickfield, the sophomore from Williamsburg, Virginia.
Yeah, and that was a solid series from her back handspring layout.
Jessica.
I'm excited to see her get more experience.
Just saw Jessica Hutchinson, a 9.95 for Denver on the floor exercise.
Ava's looking so confident on this event. This is really showing the depth that Oklahoma has and might use later on in the season. Back handspring, gainer full, stuck. Wow, what an amazing routine from her. Probably the best she's done. And that just shows Coach Kindler that she's ready. Whenever she needs to put her in, she's ready.
So the totals for those two rotations, identical. Both teams had a 49.425. Oklahoma on beam, and with Jessica Hutchinson's elite performance on floor exercise, Denver records a 49.425 on floor exercise. So Oklahoma unable to pull ahead at all on a rotation where you thought they could.
Yeah, this is going to be close.
And we see exhibition now. For Madison Reidenbach.
Opens up with that half front Rudy. Again, this is great experience for these gymnasts to get out on the floor. Their scores might not count, but their coaches are watching, as well as their teammates. And this just helps them gain more confidence. Great double back there. Great routine, showing more depth for Denver. You love to see it.
The Hudson, Wisconsin freshman, Madison Reidenbach, wrapping things up with that exhibition on the floor exercise. Oh, so close to a 10. It would have been number 6 for Reagan Smith, but she was denied. Pretty incredible, though, she was with this beam routine.
It was gorgeous. I did not see anything that they could take, but, you know?
I suppose that's why you're up here. Oh, so close, headed to the final rotation when we come back. To the final rotation, it is so close. Denver led after the opening rotation. They led by a tenth and a half of a point. Oklahoma able to rally and take the lead. They had 5 scores of 9-9 or higher on rotation number 2, the uneven bars, and had a lead of 1/4 of 1/10 of a point. We decided nothing on rotation number 3. They had dead even scores, of course, on different apparatuses, but both had a 4-9, 4-2, 5, so Oklahoma's lead remains 1/4 of 1/10 of 1 point. The slimmest of margins. We have seen Denver have above their season average on 2 rotations and a high watermark for the year on vault to be right in this thing. A look at the teams against Oklahoma will compete this year, and once again, the Sooners do not back down from any competition. 4 top 10 teams, I think you easily could put. Denver was number 8 last year. They're a top 10 team. I don't care what the rankings say.
Oh, yeah, and you can tell by tonight. You know, we're early on in the season, and they're showing it tonight that they are a top 10 team.
We take a look at the upcoming schedule for the Sooners. Oklahoma gets to host the Big 12 championships, by the way. Arizona State and Cal will have that meet on February the 2nd. Then the quad meet on the 9th here at the Lloyd Noble Center. BYU, Utah State, Texas Women's University. And then the 17th will be Arkansas, Washington, and Cal for the Sooners. Right now, we're seeing out there part of the hashtag everyone that Sooner Gymnastics has this year, and KJ Kindler has talked so much about it. It's not about you as an individual gymnast. It's about everyone, and they are talking it over as a team. You can see Tom Haley out there, longtime assistant in the middle of that huddle. But the people who prepare all the different apparatuses and get the Lloyd Noble Center ready, it takes everyone, and that's what that hashtag is all about, Natalie.
It really does. From the people that set the mats, your coaches, your athletic trainers, everyone is taking a part in Oklahoma gymnastics to help make this team great.
And just up the street, the Beerson Center is undergoing renovations, the home of Sooner men's and women's gymnastics. By the way, the Sooner men are ranked number 1. Very young team that Mark Williams has, but they've performed super effectively. They'll be at home the next couple of weekends. Not this weekend, but next weekend and the weekend after that. They'll be at home over at McCaslin Fieldhouse. So excited about them as well. 75 straight home meet wins for the Sooners dating back to 2014. That's what's at stake tonight. And up on beam is Abby Thompson, first for Denver.
Nailing that opening series. Side aerial to a back handspring. Competed in the 5th spot last week. Denver had some uncharacteristic mistakes last week on beam.
Denver ranked 11th nationally on beam.
Looking pretty solid here in this opening routine.
Abby Thompson was an individual qualifier for the NCAA championships on the beam 2 years ago.
Side aerial to a 1.5. Doesn't quite find that landing. A small hop, but a great routine to start off this rotation for Denver.
Big smile for Melissa Kutcher-Reinhart. Knows her team is right in the middle of perhaps winning in Norman tonight.
They are definitely still in it.
Oklahoma rock solid, though, on the floor exercise this year.
Starting off with senior Audrey Davis. another event that she's lead off on. Opens up with a front double full, just gorgeous. Right now, Oklahoma just needs to perform, you know, use all that energy. Show why they scored a 198 last week. Gorgeous leaps. Nice second pass, 1.5 punch front full. Audrey scored a 9.9 last week in the leadoff. She just does two passes, which is kind of controversial right now in the NCAA gymnastics world. However, she does all around, and if it saves a gymnast's body, then I'm all for it. Great routine for Audrey Davis to open up this rotation. This is going to be a close one.
What a great leadoff that was for Audrey Davis. Leadoff in three different rotations. Momo EY set to go as you look at the rankings for Denver, but they have outperformed these all night long. So far, first three rotations, they have been above their season average, including a season high on vault of 49.425. So here's EY after Abby Thompson scored a 9.75.
Momo is the 2022 Big 12 champion on this event. Opened up with that switch leap to straddle quarter. Backhand spring layout, very solid. I love that she's able to smile through her routine. Shows her confidence to herself and to the judges. Just has her dismount now. Cartwheel gainer full. Small hop backwards and a couple more after that. Not the finish she was hoping for, but a solid routine for Denver.
So Abby Thompson had a 9.75. We just saw Audrey Davis with a 9.875 for Oklahoma on floor exercise. And we now see the Georgia transfer, Soraya Hawthorne, fifth-year competitor out of Memphis, four seasons as a Georgia Bulldog. And she was second-team All-American on floor exercise a season ago.
Chad, the judges are being kind of strict tonight.
Well, I wasn't going to say anything, but they are.
She has such a fun floor routine. Coach Kindler is excited that she gets to be out there to show it off, and she just gets better and better each week. Opens up with a huge double pike. Can tell just got a little spring out of there, but was able to hold it.
Be honest, Natalie, are you tapping your foot over there?
I am. This is a routine that I would love to see on the national stage. You know, she is a fifth year transferred into this program. It takes a lot to come into a whole new team and wrap your arms around the culture, the girls, but Coach Kindler says she has done an amazing job and she fits right in.
Coach Kindler said, I am honest with any transfer portal athletes about how difficult and the expectations at Oklahoma.
Front layout to a Rudy to a split. Great finish for her. Really selling the end of that routine. Great routine for Soraya to continue for Oklahoma on the floor.
And I'm going to listen to Earth, Wind, and Fire on the drive home, too.
Here's that last pass again. Front layout to a Rudy. Split jump. So excited about that routine.
So Audrey Davis, 9.875 for Davis in the leadoff position. So far on beam, Abby Thompson a 9.75, and Momo EY also had a 9.75. Here's Rosie Casale. She's also one of the four pioneers competing in the all-around.
Was not in the balance beam lineup last week. Opened up with a backhand spring layout, just a little bit off on the landing. Switch leap. Cartwheel, gainer full, small step on the dismount. You know, it's really gonna come down to these small details like steps. And so far, I haven't seen a stuck dismount from Denver yet.
And so far, Oklahoma has gained 0.2 of a point through the first two competitors on each rotation. And now to Reagan Smith, 9-time NCAA All-American, first team All-American on floor exercise in the past. She's fantastic on this rotation.
She has a mashup of Taylor Swift songs. So I would say Taylor Swift eras routine. Opens up with a double back. Lands kind of short on that. This is definitely a routine you can have fun with the crowd in. Run up 1.5 front layout. This is my favorite music out of this mashup. Last week she had such a great floor routine. You could just see it on her face. You know, she started off a little bit different this time, but she's finishing it out here. Just her last pass now. Double pike, way better landing. Great finish for Reagan Smith. To continue the Oklahoma floor rotation.
Sooners solid, if not spectacular, on the floor exercise so far. And Reagan Smith holding up that part.
Yeah, and here's that opening pass again. You could just see she was a little bit too open in the air, causing her to take a step, but really recovered on those last two passes.
So Denver needing to gain some ground now. Just saw Rosie Casale's routine scored a 9.65. And now Madison Ulrich.
She had the second highest score last week for her team on this event with a 9.8. Beautiful back handspring layout. She's looking very poised and aggressive. Something you want to see out of a freshman. Just her front aerial right there. Just her dismount now. Backhand spring 1.5. Doesn't quite get that stick, but glues her feet together pretty fast, and that might be the best routine I've seen so far for Denver on beam.
A high-level freshman, Madison Ulrich, an all-arounder from the get-go for the Pioneers, and she completes her night with the best individual routine we have seen from Denver on the balance beam. Over to Kat Levasseur, ready to take her turn on floor exercise after Reagan Smith's 9.80, and Oklahoma really separating on this final rotation of the night.
I love watching Kat on this event. Opens up with a strong full in. Finds that landing. Thank you.
Coach Kindler was saying how fortunate it was to just have seniors that are able to compete in the lineup. You know, that's not super common. Just hitting those splits, 180. She had a 9.95 last week. Giving away little to zero deduction. One and a half front half to a straddle jump. Pretty perfect to me. Excellent routine from Kat Levasseur.
Kat Levasseur bringing fans to their feet at the Lloyd Noble Center.
Her form and technique is just unmatched. You can tell on that last pass, her legs are glued together.
Back to the beam quickly for Riley Mundell. Fifth competitor for Denver on the beam. High score so far, 9.875 from Madison Ulrich. Oklahoma's Reagan Smith has the overall beam high score of 9.75.
Starts off with a beautiful back handspring layout. Has a little wobble on a full turn. Sometimes the easiest of skills are the ones we wobble on. Just her dismount, round off 1.5. Small hop on that landing, but a good routine. Just a little bit of deduction here and there. But so far, this Denver team is doing much better on this event than they did last week.
Final routine of the night there for Riley Mundell. We get back to the Sooner floor exercise, and Kat Levasseur just scored a 9.925 for Oklahoma. Really ramping it up. And here's Faith Torres.
Faith is one to watch on this event. Has a huge double layout to open up her routine. Just so automatic. Quick on her feet and makes it look so easy. You can see KJ, Coach Kindler over there, proud of the routines that she creates. She choreographs every single routine for these gymnasts.
And that's a huge part of it.
Just her last pass now, tucked through to a double back. Nails it, a great routine for Faith there. She scored a 9.85 last week. This will definitely beat that.
Well, she was a first-team All-American on floor exercise last season, shared the Big 12 title on this apparatus as well. And this is one of those routines that can win you titles.
There's that last pass again, just nails it. She knows that's a great routine.
Just saw Kat Levasseur with a 9.925. We'll get Faith Torres' score in a moment. And we get to Jessica Hutchinson, final regular competitor on the balance beam. And she's also in the all-around, which, by the way, Bowers and Hutchinson were separated by 0.25 of a point in the all-around coming into this final rotation. We'll see Jordan Bowers closing things out for the Sooners on the floor in a moment.
Beautiful switch leap to a split jump. She has such beautiful lines and great tempo. Solid front toss. Just her dismount now to close out this rotation for Denver. Cartwheel gainer full, gets the stick. The best routine for Denver, definitely on the beam.
Well, Faith Torres just tied her career high on floor exercise with a 9.925. I beg your pardon, a 9.950 is her career high. So she just set a new career high.
And yeah,
Oklahoma,
no, that was pretty.
They have been excellent on floor exercise, and Jordan Bowers now to cap it.
Jordan is one of my favorites to watch on this event. She really eyes down her teammates, the fans, the camera, even her coaches, and is truly in full character. Opens up with a front double full to a punch front. Gorgeous. With a double pike here. Super high flying, able to hold that. Selling this routine to the crowd, the judges, everyone. Putting a cap on this meet. Just gorgeous leaps. Superb job from Jordan Bowers. What a great routine and a great way to close out this meet for Oklahoma.
We will wait for her score and see about the all-around competition. Jessica Hutchinson had a 9.95 on the beam. And once again, they were separated by 1/4 of 1/10 of a point. But Oklahoma explodes on the floor exercise. And they have turned a close meet into a fairly comfortable win when it's all said and done. Now we see exhibitions. First up, Madison Reidenbach on the balance beam for the Pioneers.
Again, these gymnast scores might not count, but they're gaining that experience that they need. Huge opening series, backhand spring layout. And it's so solid. Having this depth just gives coaches on every team that insurance as we head towards postseason. So far, she's looking very solid. Just her dismount, round off 1.5. Wow, that was a great routine, and who knows, maybe it'll be in the lineup next week for Denver.
So Madison Reidenbach there. Just saw Jordan Bowers with a 9.95 on floor exercise. We have a three-way tie for that event title between Torres and Bowers of Oklahoma and Hutchinson of Denver. And now Belle Johnson, final routine of the night, an exhibition on the floor exercise for Belle.
She has such a fun routine, Barbie-themed. Definitely going to get the crowd involved in this one. You know, she has been a solid competitor on this event and is ready to go in whenever.
Started her career as a walk-on and now a full part.
Opened up with that beautiful front layout, Rudy. We'll be right back. double back. Great routine. Wow. Just showing that depth again that Oklahoma has and might use later down the road, as well as the fun dance involved. Great exhibition routine from Bell. And a great close to this meet.
Well, Oklahoma is able to pull away after leading by just one quarter of one-tenth of a point. They're able to really put some distance between the two teams on the final rotation. As Oklahoma, their floor rotation ends up at a 49.575. They're able to pull away and win, though it was not comfortable. 49.575 is a season high for Oklahoma. Beg your pardon, it's not a season high. It's above their season average for the Sooners on the floor exercise. But in the end, what made the difference on that final rotation, Natalie?
Just those landings and, you know, routine after routine. You know, you can look at the score right now, and Oklahoma did make some mistakes, but it's still a pretty good score. And it was a close meet up until that last event. And it was great for both teams to be tested in that environment.
We have some individual event winners to tell you about as well. Jessica Hutchinson for Denver, winning the all-around tonight by the slimmest of margins. The Sooners win the home opener on banner-raising night. We'll recap it when we return. Oklahoma wins it tonight. They pulled away on the final rotation. The floor exercise was good to Oklahoma this evening as the Sooners had a closer meet with Denver tonight than they did a week ago up in Denver. We take a look at our final score presented by Taco Mayo. Big appetite, bigger savings. Download and save today. So for the Sooners, 197.775 is below their season average. Again, a few jitters. Big night, a lot of energy when you raise a banner like this and your first time in front of the home crowd. But as you said, Natalie, important to get this out of the way.
Yeah, it is. And it really is a good test just going into the meets that they have ahead. You know, this is the fourth meet. They're just getting started. And, yeah, they've looked pretty lights out up until now. But every team is going to have mistakes here and there.
Individual event winners, Jessica Hutchinson of Denver, a 9.95 on vault. Jordan Bowers of Oklahoma, 9.975 on bars. Reagan Smith wins the beam title with a 9.975. A three-way tie on the floor exercise. Hutchinson of Denver ties it with Bowers and Torres of Oklahoma. So they share that individual event title. And the all-around win goes to the two-time Big 12 Gymnast of the Year, Jessica Hutchinson of Denver. And she just barely outdistanced Oklahoma's Jordan Bowers by 1/4 of 1/10 of a point in this one. Oh, so close in that all-around, Natalie.
Yeah, it was a very close one, and all of those gymnasts really excelled tonight and held it together for their teams.
And our gymnast of the night, presented by Love's Travel Stops, the heart of the highway, Jessica Hutchinson in very good form once again. Oklahoma wins it overall. Good crowd of filing out of the Lloyd Noble Center as the Sooners improve to a perfect 10-0 on the season. And Denver falls to 5-2. Very enjoyable night at the Lloyd Noble Center, beginning with the raising of the banner and the back-to-back NCAA championships recognized. For my partner, Natalie Brown, the former Sooner gymnast, now Natalie Walker, I'm Chad McKee. We appreciate it. Thanks to our great crew. We'll talk to you next time on Sooner Vision from ESPN+.